Hi, Odooers, and welcome. Product variants are used to manage products that have different variations, like a t-shirt with different sizes and colors. It's key in many industries where variants are a part of life, such as the fashion industry. Product differentiation is a marketing strategy that involves making distinct changes and goods to make them stand out. At Stealthy Wood, we use this strategy to increase our sales and keep our customers interested in our company. Product variants make life so much easier, allowing your company to offer various purchase options for products. Your customers will have access to a broad variety of goods, and they will get exactly what they want and feel more satisfied with their purchase. Lastly, product differentiation will strengthen your relationships with your customers over the long term. For these reasons, using product variants with Odoo is highly advantageous. You will have the possibility to create new variants for different products, to add them directly to your database and sell them through your salespeople and your online shop without the customers realizing the complexity of your inventory. So let's check this out in our Stealthy Wood database. All right, here I am on my database. So let's go ahead and jump to the sales application, and then we're going to go to configuration settings where we're going to activate the variants option. So we see that right away at the top. Okay, I already have this activated, so let's check out our attributes. I can simply click on this button right here, or I can go to configuration attributes. Right away, we're gonna see a list of all of the attributes that are already in my system. So I have legs, size, color, gender, and duration. I'm also gonna be able to see the display type, so how I would like the values displayed. So I have radio, color, and select. And I'm going to be able to see the variant creation mode as well. So when I would like the variants to be created. And all of these I have selected as instantly. Now to create a new attribute, all you have to do is click on create. You'll add your attribute name, and then you'll select your display type between the options mentioned before, radio select color, and also your variants creation mode, instantly, dynamically, or never. Now, please note that once an attribute has actually been created, or a variant, excuse me, has been created for this attribute, you will not be able to modify this. All right, so let's go ahead and check out an attribute that I've already created, one that many, many businesses use, which is color. Then we're going to click on edit. As you can see, I can edit the display type and the name, but I cannot edit the creation mode because I do have variants that have already been created with this attribute. Okay, then down below, we're going to have all of our values. So I'm going to have all of my colors here, gray, white, black, blue, pink, yellow, and rainbow. I'm going to be able to say if it's a custom value, and I can also add the HTML color code here as well. So let me go ahead and show you how this works. So let's say purple, it's not a custom value. And I'm gonna click on the circle in order to add the HTML color code. So I want to determine what specific purple I want. So I'm gonna choose this one here, looks good. And then I can save. Something else we can see here are the related products to this attribute. So my customizable desk and my company t-shirt both come in different colors. All right, so that's super easy to set up. Now that we've seen how to create an attribute, let's go ahead and apply this attribute to one of my products. So I'm gonna go to products, and I'm gonna choose my basic lamp. I don't have any variants for this product just yet. So let's jump over to the variants tab and click on edit. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and add a line. Let's choose color and then some values as well. So we're gonna say purple, rainbow, and gray. Okay, I'm only selecting the colors that I actually have in stock, that I actually sell for this product. Okay, if later on I decide that I also want to sell my basic lamp in another color, I can always add it after the fact. So let's save this. Once I click on save, I'm going to see my three variants here. Okay, since I have the variant creation set up to be instant. All right, and I will be able to configure them as well. So if I click on configure variants, I'm going to have some of my basic information, such as attribute, value, the display type, the HTML color index, and I'm also going to be able to add an extra price on specific variants as well, which is really cool. So let's go ahead and do that for my rainbow lamp. I have a really high demand for this lamp, so I'm going to go ahead and make it a bit more expensive than the others. Let's say it's $5 more. And I can also say if this attribute value should not be compatible with other values for this product or for other values with accessory or optional products as well related to this one. Okay, I'm not going to do that for the lamp though, so I'm going to click on save, but let's go ahead and check out another product where I do have that set up. So I'm going to go to my customizable desk and I'm going to click on configure variants. And we're gonna go ahead and choose my customizable desk with aluminum legs. All right, so first of all, I do have a price extra for this value, but I also see that this value is not compatible, for example, with a conference chair with legs of steel or with the same product, but the desk that comes in black. Okay, so for example, on my product configurator, if I choose my customizable desk and the color is black, I will not be able to choose the legs as aluminum. All right, but now that we've seen how we can set this up on the product template, let's go ahead and create a quotation. So we're gonna go to orders, quotations, create. I'm gonna choose my customer, Adrian L. And then I'm going to purchase my basic lamp. Okay, immediately I'm gonna see my product configurator pop up, and I do have the product configurator option activated on the settings page, so be sure you do that if you want to see the same thing as me. All right, and then I'm gonna be able to choose any color I would like. So first of all, the first one is rainbow. I didn't select an HTML color code, so it's just blank. But I do see that the price, the extra price that I added to my rainbow lamp is $5 more. So it has applied here, and the purple is just 40, the gray is just 40 as well. All right, so let's go ahead and add that. Then we can save and complete the flow. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching, and if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.